which opened while we were there. We thought it was very well done, and the Dolby sound, we got a sense of being on a ship in the Pacific during the sea battles. Later, we both remarked on what the world must have been like in those terrible years of World War II. How war in Europe and in the Pacific were consuming the world and taking lives, causing suffering and death around the globe. A terrifying time. Both of our fathers and uncles were serving in Europe and the Pacific, and we know from our family stories, our reading, how devastating and life-changing were those years. Did those who lived in that time think that they were living in the end times? And yet the world survived and went on. Today we have places and events that are troubling and cause us fear. We worry and wonder what it all means and what is around the corner. That is why I think that today's readings, especially the gospel, give us hope and assurance in a time of uncertainty. Jesus tells his disciples that all things, wars and rumors of wars, earthquakes, famines, plagues, floods, and more, all will happen. But only God knows the end time. As each of us lives our lives day to day, we will experience good times and challenging times, times of joy and peace, and times of doubt and turmoil, fear and loss, but also times of calm and rest and assurance. This is the stuff of life, my friends, all of it. And we are to hear Jesus' words to us, as to his disciples, who would experience all manner of persecution in the healing and teaching in his name. They would give up their very lives, literally, by following him and preaching his gospel, his good news. This is where Jesus says something quite unusual. He says, by your endurance, you will gain your souls. In the disciples' endurance in these hard and difficult times, when their very lives are in danger, they will have the opportunity to testify. And the words that they are to use will come to them, so they should not worry about what they're going to say. They are to trust that they will have what they need. Bring that to our 21st century experience. How are we to live out our faith and reach out in a way that confronts the evils of our own world? And at the same time be true to Jesus and nourish our souls in the process. Do we trust that we will have what we need? We complete this church year, and the calendar year is in its final quarter. We have the opportunity to take stock of our lives as persons of faith and as citizens of the world we live in. The two are intertwined, so that we are to be witnesses to the faith that we proclaim. And in the process, we can change the world around us, not just survive, but thrive. Sounds lofty. Paying attention to our prayer life, gathering together for worship each week, attending a seasonal retreat. We have one coming up in Advent on December 7th at the Dominican Center. Reaching out to our community with parish ministries, agencies, and other programs in Grand Rapids and beyond. We will strengthen our own faith and sense of purpose. We are to be intentional living out our faith. We can be more mindful, which is a Buddhist term which means to be aware of everything that you do every day. Mindfulness is the equivalent of the Holy Spirit, the energy of God. This thought comes from Thich Nhat Hanh, a Buddhist holy man who wrote Jesus and Buddha as brothers in many more ways. We can work to maintain healthy bodies so that we are better able to thrive, not just survive in this complicated and stressful world. remember that as we endure,